Hello, yo, this is Eternal Place. Exactly, Mario Kart 8 is what we're gonna play. So, yeah, it's time for us to actually play some of our newer games, because you basically see me do less plays after their old games, such as from the 90s or the early 2000s. This game, however, is, well, not really super new, but it's still brand new, it's only 3 years old. And I'm playing, of course, the Wii U version of Mario Kart 8. So, what if we are to do here in Mario Kart 8, you might think? Well, there's a lot of things we can do, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to play through all the cups, the 8 original cups, the 4 DLC cups. I also tried through the time trials, I tried the online mode, tried the battle mode, and I even take a trip in the 200cc. Let's talk a bit more about Mario Kart 8. So, when you start up the game, you have the menu here, single player, multiplayer, online 1 player, online 2 players, Mario Kart TV, and yeah. The shop, where you can buy DLC characters and stages and so on that has been on sale earlier. You can also press the select button to go to the stats screen, where you can see my stats as of this moment. And of course, if I go to the plus or start button, I can have the amiibo screen, where I can touch an amiibo in order to get amiibos to be used on my Wii U. But of course, I don't have an amiibo, so I guess we have to do without it. But let's get it started. So I decided I'm going to do every cup, 12 cups. I'll do one cup per episode, and I'll do a few episodes of time trials, online mode, battle mode, and 200cc. So let's get started, shall we? Let's go with single player. You go to single player, you have some choice there. You can go Grand Prix, time trial, versus race, or battle mode. And I decided that since we're going to go with all the cups, we'll go with Grand Prix. When you select Grand Prix, you get to select exactly what kind of difficulty you want to run. You have the 50cc, 100cc, 150cc, mirror mode, which is basically 150cc with everything being mirrored. And then you have the 200cc, which is basically insane mode, I will call it. It's so fast that I'm not really going to try to do any cup of it, because it's just insane in the membrane. So I'm gonna go with 50cc for the first cup. I'll do the other cups in the other difficulties, such as 100cc and 150cc. Maybe I'll even do some mirror modes playing as well in the episode of its own. We'll see. So let's start with 50cc for the first cup. Here we have the roster of Mario Kart 8. We have Mario, Luigi, Peach, Daisy, Rosalina, Metal Mario. We have Toadette, we have Lakitu, Green Shy Guy. You can of course change him to other colors, such as red one. Koopa Troopa, Toad, Yoshi, we can also change colors. Baby Mario, Baby Luigi, Baby Peach, Baby Daisy, Baby Rosalina, and Pinkle Peach, which is a very weird character. You have the Koopalings, Roy, Iggy, you have Morton, Ludwig, Wendy, Larry, which is my favorite character, and Lemmy. You also have Bowser, Donkey Kong, Wario, and Waluigi. And of course, you can also play as your Mii character, which I have mine here. And on the bottom, we have DLC characters such as Tanuki Mario, Cat Peach, Link. Yep, Link from Zelda can be played. You have Villager from Animal Crossing. We also have Isabelle from Animal Crossing. And of course, Dry Bowser, first seen in New Super Mario Bros. For Nintendo DS, I think. Of course, Tanuki Mario we've seen in Super Mario Bros. 3. Cat Peach we saw in Super Mario 3D World. Of course, what better way to start off this Let's Play by playing as the guy himself, Mario. When you select Mario, you get to come to the customization settings. We can select what kind of vehicle we want to drive. We can drive a motorcycle. We can even drive a motorcycle. We can drive. We can drive a four-wheeler, of course, if we want to do that. We can have the original carts. We can even drive some cars. They even have other cars in this game. That's kind of weird. And yeah, you have bikes, as you've probably seen. So a lot of customization on how you want to drive. It's kind of up to you how you want to drive. Let's go with the classic with a kart. I have some wheels you can also use. Just go with the regular wheels. Gliders, just what you use for gliding, which is a feature introduced to Mario Kart 7. I just take your super glider. Here we have the cups. Mushroom cup, flower cup, star cup, and special cup, which are the new courses in Mario Kart 8. Then we have the retro courses with shell cup, banana cup, leaf cup, lightning cup. These are cups with courses from past games, and you have the DLC cups, which is the Egg Cup, Crossing Cup, Triforce Cup, and Bell Cup, which are all mix of new courses and old courses. So let's get started. We're gonna play in the Mushroom Cup. Let's go with Mario Kart Stadium as our very first track. This will be exciting. I'm really looking forward to this. Let's start off with the Mushroom Cup in this very first episode. So we have Mario Kart Stadium played on 50cc. Quite beautiful place. And here we go! First race! And we start by 3, 2, 1, and go! We begun the Mario Kart 8 game Let's Play! Of course, this one's a bit easier. So you see there's a lot of things here. We have the question mark, which are like item blocks. You can use them to get anything from items to coins. Coins are basically increasing. Oh my, I just got hit by a green shell. Yeah, these things can be thrown at others to stop you, slow you down, etc. Coins, of course, are to increase your max speed. You have a maximum of 10 coins, and the more coins you have, the more speed you have total. If you get hit by things, you will lose coins, so it's good to get stuck on them up as soon as you can. The item I had before was a banana, which you can use to just toss down, which will slow the enemy a bit. I get more coins now, I'm up to 9. The thing I see doing here where I get some color on my back of my vehicle is called sliding. Just hold on the R button and then you just tilt your control stick to the direction you want to go. And the more you do like this, the more you get. If you go to the blue, you get some tilting. If you go all the way to become yellow, you get even more speed. The green shell, you can hold down the left button to hold it down as a protective shell. If you hold down the down control spark, then you can throw the shell backwards. If not, you'll just throw it forward. So a lot of people do like to have green shell where they have one on them and they have one where they just keep on them. Also, if you press the R button when you're doing a jump, you get a little boost of speed, which is pretty cool. It's cool to do some cool tricks here. We're about to go into the last lap, third lap now. All tracks in this game have 3 laps, except for one track, which I'll get to later when we go to that cup. More coins. Yeah, get more coins on 10 is basically a waste, but that's fine. Also be like an asshole, just take the coins over others. That will be a bit, a bit evil. But again, this is all about winning. So we need to make sure you stay in first place. There was a banana, you don't want to go into that banana. You can see on the map on the right there, I'm quite in the lead with Bowser and Peach on second and third. This is a little trick. Padana, let's just do a trick here. R button. Little cool trick, that was kind of cool. I slide through, and the first, very first track, Mario Kart Stadium is done! I finish on first place. After that, you get the points for this map. You can see Mario, Bowser, Peach, Toad, Baby Mario, Luigi, Toadette, Shy Guy, Baby Peach, Daisy, Link, and Cat Peach. Yeah, Peach, there's 3 Peaches here. Nowhere we don't have Pink or Peach either. No Koopalings though, but that's fine. So this is basically how it looks. You have 12 users, then you have the total ranking, which you of course don't see because this is the first one. You go to the next race, you can view the highlight reel to see highlights from your just driven race. You can quit if you don't want to continue. You can also press the start button to make this as a favorite, and it will be stored on the Mario Kart TV, which we'll go through later. Let's go for the next track in the Mushroom Cup. So from Mario Kart Stadium, we're gonna go a bit of a fun land. Welcome to Water Park. This is like almost like an amusement park, sort of. A lot of water elements. Should be our next track here in the Mushroom Cup. We will start on the first now because we were first place last time. If you hold the drive by just as the one goes or the two goes, you get some boost. I didn't get it this time. Get some coins, which are always nice to have. Here we have a bit of ways we can slide through. And woo! Nice done there, Mario. Now we are underwater, which is a new thing introduced in Mario Kart 7. Because usually when you go in the water in Mario Kart games, you are basically screwed. Now, the thing we're doing right now is kind of cool. We're actually sliding in a different direction. Like you see here, we're just going to go sliding down through. It's one of the new things in Mario Kart 8, which is the gravity thing that you just can drive on the side, can drive upside down. Doesn't really matter. Here we have the sliding, which of course we've seen already in the previous track. This is a new feature introduced in Mario Kart 7 on Nintendo 3DS. And that was the first lap. So this is a pretty simple map. Again, just to know that, yeah, I play Mario Kart for a lot of years, but I don't want to consider myself as a super pro, so you might think that I'm not really good at this game, but then again, I'm not really trying to be good either, I'm just trying to have fun. Now we see we're driving almost upside down, which is kind of a cool part of this new feature in Mario Kart 8. Get some more coins, but I don't really need to. A lot of banana shells here though. Try not to run into them or you'll be slowed down. Maybe you lose some coins. Mushroom. Now mushroom is a pretty decent item. Can be very useful. It only gives you very just small bar of speed like this. Which of course can be very useful in case you are a bit behind. More coins, which is not really very useful, but that's fine. I can live with that. Jump in the water. Now, if you see these wheels in the middle here, if you run into them, you spin around and you actually get a little boost of speed. So when you are in the gravitational places in the tracks, if you run into others, instead of you losing coins or they're knocking you away, you will both spin and you get a moment of speed. So actually, it's very good to hit others when you are driving gravitational places in Mario Kart 8, which is pretty cool. We're about to finish this track. Just drop a shell because there's not really ways used to do it. And we are at the finish line, and we finish first again. And again, this is not supposed to be like hard or anything. I'm just showing you guys off the tracks. So you see now my points allocated. We see that I have 6-point lead to Bowser, Peach on third. Here we see the standings. We see here that Baby Peach has gone up 2 spots, with Link also bypassing Daisy, while Cat Peach is still in last place with only 2 points. Which is a bit of a fun thing. Alright, let's go to the next race. We have still 2 more tracks to do in this cup before we end this episode, before we go on to the Flower Cup in the next episode. Let's see what we get this time. Oh yeah, this is one of my favorite tracks actually. Sweet, sweet canyon. You wanna drive a place where it's just filled with candy and candy floss and chocolate and fizzy drinks and everything. This will be your paradise. Place just filled with candy and sweets. 3, 2, 1, and go! Got a bit of boost of speed, but not that much. I can get more, of course. Let's go through this very cool tunnel here. Need to get some lights because it's a bit dark in here. Let's just throw off the shell. And now we fly off the other side of the place. We have a bit of a steep swing here. Just to slide your way through. Now we're inside fizzy drinks. This is pretty cool. The blue spots here indicate that this will be a gravitational field, which means that the place will be tilting a bit in terms of gravity. See that my wheels are now flattened instead of being round on as usual. We're just more about the gravitational places. Oh, this one is cool. This one, the blooper. This put up ink on the screen, which makes it a bit harder to see where you are. So I just didn't see that there was a field here, so I'll be slowing down a bit. And the last jump here, and there we go. We are in the finish line, and we are on lap number 2. 2 more laps to go. Inside this tunnel again, we have a red shell. Now this one is pretty useless as in first place, but this one is dark and green shell. However, this is a homing missile sort of shell. This means that if someone is ahead of you and you use the red shell, then that shell will hit the guy ahead of you in the score. So if you are on second place, it will try to go for the one on first place, which is pretty nice. Gives a little advantage to catch up in case they are ahead of you, or if you are, you know, been unlucky, but hit a lot of things and you had to get back in the lead or want to get at least upwards in the standings. Of course, this will be more important for me when I go through the 150 CZs, because that's going to be computer players, so it's going to be much harder to race against. And we are going in here. Oh, this one special! Boom! that, ladies and gentlemen, is what people call the bane of Mario Kart, the blue shell. Blue shell has spikes in it, and it's basically a shell that goes automatically for the leader. Also, it also goes in the middle of the track, at least it did in the previous games, so that if you were in the middle of the track, you could get hit by the shell. Now, the blue shell in previous games were unavoidable. That means if you were in the lead, there was absolutely no chance for you to dodge the blue shell. But in Mario Kart 8, we also have the super horn, which is a thing that blasts every item that's about to hit you, even the blue shell. The thing that also saw we get hit by there was the lightning cloud. The lightning cloud is an item that's usually used by people at the very end of the standings. They basically put up a lightning that strikes everyone in the field, except for you, which will make them stop a bit, and then they'll become small, which means they'll be running slower, and they can also be hit by the bigger guys and be flattened out. So very useful to have if you're far behind. And with that, we finish the third level, Sweet Sweet Canyon. You see, I'm quite ahead in the lead. I have a 9-point lead, but I still can lose the standings if I drop to the bottom place. Look at Cat Peach, though, with an 8th place. Still on the second last, though, but Shy Guy just now went back to 7th place. That's pretty good of Shy Guy there. Top 6, of course, are more or less the same. But that was the Sweet Sweet Canyon, which means we have one more track to do before we finish off this episode, which is the last track in the Mushroom Cup. One of my favorite tracks, actually, of the whole game. Let us play it. Thwomp Ruins! Yeah, finally these enemies from Mario Worlds, all the way from the first Mario games, they finally have their own sort of world. Thwomp Ruins. Final race. Here we go. Here we go on two. There we go. Now this is how you get a boost. When the guys locator shows you the two sign, that's when you should push the acceleration button, the A button. Then you can speed up. This one's a bit of a cool feel as well. Just go on the side here, try not to get hit. Now you see the middle here is closed, but that'll be opened up in the other laps. Go on the left here as well to go some anti-gravity. Like this. And then we have a little tunnel. You see the blue pads come up, which means this place is about to tilt a bit in terms of anti-gravity. There's some shortcuts here too. I'll try to do them later on. Oh boy, I got hit by a green shell. Damn it. Well, like I'm in danger now. I'm still in the lead there, so I got a shortcut on the left there. I'll try to do it in the other laps. And we have a little jet flying gliding here. And we are in the finish line. This is Thwomp Ruins. That was the first lap. We still have two more laps to go. Let's see what we bring this time. We have some coins here. Let's bring up those coins. And we can go on the right here. Do some anti-gravity. Let's do that. Do some speeds and you get some item in the end, which I kind of failed to. In the middle here, you can do some gliding. Watch out for the Thwomp in the middle though. Don't want to get hit by it. In the water, and yeah, that's a bit of a shortcut here. Let's go around on the side here so we can pass through. Let's see if we can land on this shortcut now. Let's see. You may need the mushroom to go through here. Oh, I managed it. That's cool. I did it. I think I was had a usual mushroom, but I guess I've been just playing this map a lot of times. And that was lap number two. We have the last final lap. See if things become more interesting now. Throw off the banana peel. Oh, that was on the grass. Not really very effective there. That's fine. Watch out for these things here. Don't get hit by it. Just slide on the intersection. Try on the right this time. Let's see. Don't hit with impact Thwomp. Oh, that was close. If I had gone more to left there, I would have been flattened by that Thwomp. They're not really nice to you. And again, they have been your enemies in regular Bowser Castle since Mario Bros. 3, I think. So, it's kind of common that they don't want to be your friend. Let's put on the banana peel and let's just cross over here. On the last jump, here we go. And the finish line is just ahead of us and we score down to a perfect win. And the Mushroom Cup 50cc is done! Catpitch now in 6th place, that was pretty good. Catpitch has been so good in the last few tracks. Let's see how much place it went up now. Only one, I guess. Yeah, it went up one more, so that's pretty good. I went the course with 60 points, of course you got 15 points per track. Let's see how it goes now with the ceremony. View results. Here we have some highlights from me driving. Pretty cool. This is also what you can do yourself with storing your tracks on Mario Kart TV. You can see me drive on the Mario Kart Stadium, which was the first track in the Mushroom Cup. Here we have the list to see. I'm first place, Mario Kart Stadium, Water Park, Sweet Canyon, and Thwomp Ruins in Mushroom Cup on 50cc. Cross the line, and I'm happy. Mario celebrating, just a cool guy he is. Here we see the congratulations! I get a 3-star, which is the best you can get. And I get the cool 50cc Mushroom Cup trophy. And that's basically it for this episode. Now we've seen how Mario Kart 8 works. In next episode, we're gonna go up a level to the 100cc. We're gonna go through the Flower Cup. So, like, comment, and subscribe. Follow me on Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook. And that's it for now. So I'll see you guys next time as my story of Mario Kart 8 continues.